Hi, I am Ceren, and I'm going to talk about symmetric unions and how they appear in the context of an open question regarding Jones polynomial. In 1984, Jones defined a very powerful invariant called the Jones polynomial for oriented links in S3. And we know that this polynomial is just one for the unknot. However, we still don't know if there exist other knots besides the unknot that has the Jones polynomial as one. It's like a trivial Jones polynomial. But when we consider other powerful invariants like Alexander polynomial, the same question has actually answered a long time ago. And here is we know that there are actually infinitely many knots with trivial Alexander polynomial. And here is an example of such a family called the Knoch-Stenter second knot family. In fact, when producing this family, Knoch-Stenter-Isaac actually comes up with a more general construction called construction of knots called a symmetric union of symmetric unions. And these are knot diagrams defined as follows. For a given diagram D, we consider is the connected sum of D and its mirror in a way that the resulting diagram admits an excess of mirror symmetry. And we are also allowed to insert crossings along the axis, and the resulting diagram is called the symmetric union of D. And the isotopy type of D, say, denoted by J, called the partial knot. And we know that the partial knots carry a lot of information about symmetric unions. Here are some examples of symmetric unions. For instance, the Stewart-Adder knot as a symmetric union of the trefoil. And all the knots in Knoch-Stenter-Isaacs family are also symmetric unions. And you can easily work it out to see that the partial knot in this case is the unknot. And for this kind of knots, for these symmetric unions, Knoch-Stenter-Isaacs actually shows that their Alexander polynomial depends only on the parity of the inserted crossings. So by using this construction, first of all, the previous result regarding the Alexander polynomial of the Knoch-Stenter-Isaacs knot implies immediately. And also you can use this construction to produce infinitely many knots with same and trivial Alexander polynomial. So we wonder if we can find a similar relation for Jones polynomial, and the Tanaka derives such a formula in terms of the Jones polynomial of the partial knot of the symmetric union and the number of inserted crossings. And even further, when we assume K is NP-chiral, this formula becomes quite simplified as follows. And because we know that for the NP-chiral links, the Jones polynomial have palindromic coefficients. So Jones polynomial is actually a very good way to obstruct NP-chirality, can be a good tool to obstruct NP-chirality. Then from this, Tanaka immediately observes that if we find a symmetric union of the unknot, which is non-trivial and NP-chiral, then the Jones polynomial will be trivial. And we basically answer the question of that we stated at the beginning of the talk. And actually, even the question of the knots with the same Jones polynomial, the Kononobu knots are historically the first first examples to provide such families of knots with the same Jones polynomial, and they also they're also actually a symmetric union. So it's very, so when you work around these problems, actually symmetric union construction is a strong tool because the construction allows you to work with these tools very easily. And then if the answer to the problem of knots of non-trivial knots with trivial Jones polynomial is affirmative. I mean, if there exists such knot, it's very natural to expect such knots in among symmetric unions. But however, by using same techniques with Kovanov homology, I actually show that this is unfortunately not the case. Like such a knot does not exist. And the proof is actually, the proof is as follows. So the common homology is the categorification of Jones polynomial, but detection result is actually known in terms of Jones polynomial, such that if basically the common homology with rational coefficient, if for a knot, if it has rank two, then it is the unknot. And similar to the coefficient condition for the Jones polynomial, for amphichiral links, there is also a relation that was highlighted in purple for the common homology of the amphichiral link. So we basically employ some tools in common homology and show that these two conditions cannot satisfy at the same time for these knots. Thank you for listening.